Hey gang, this is Stormy. Thank you guys so much for joining me back here in Legendary. And I know it's been a few days, and I hope you haven't all forgotten about this one. I know I haven't, because I couldn't forget about this nether because I've been thinking about it. So here's hoping that all the thought I've put into it keeps us from getting our asses kicked too bad. This is a classic CTM map made by Vechs, and we're playing in version 1.4.7. And in the last episode, didn't we find that great big scary looking spider thing last episode, you guys? I think so. So, I mean, it's been a few days. You know what? I need to actually tear this down. I'll do this while I chat. We need these blocks. Hi, Pigman, how are ya? I need these blocks. Yeah, need these, thanks. Thank you, Pigman, wow. You guys, you know what? I think I put up episode 5 or 6 of Super Hostile Online today. Guess what I still haven't made in that map, and I don't really see any great big tearing hurry to do so, and that's a pick. Like, seriously, that's crazy, isn't it? But this is Legendary, and we do have a pick in here. We have a level 30 diamond pick. We're also rocking a level 30 diamond sword that I don't think I had last time. I'm guessing not, because it has no durability taken out of it. It's been a few days. Really don't remember entirely all that clearly, but I know we haven't finished the taco dungeon, so we're going to go finish the taco dungeon, right? And we are going to see if we can find the wool in here. Now what we're going to want to do, now that I'm looking at our bar, let's take that off the bar, let's put that on the bar, because we're going to want a regen potion. Obviously, regen is worth its weight in gold in here. Wow! Hey, jeez, I jumped. You stupid spider, you scared me. Where'd you come from? You ninja spider from up there somewhere. Let's see if we can figure out where. Also, blocks. We need blocks because this nether takes a lot of blocks. There's a lot of bedrock and stuff. And a lot of areas that it doesn't seem like he gave us, you know, like nifty pre-made paths to walk on and stuff. Is that a spawner? It is. Cool. So there's like a structure to these skeleton like fun box things. Can I get to my bow? Ow. And let's knock him out. And I see another skeleton fun box over there. You guys need to go away. Go away. Go away. Now the knockback on this sword could be really handy if we manage to have to tangle with some pigmen. So that's kind of a happy thought. It's not really, but well, at least we have an appropriate tool if that happens. Ah, where are you? Oh, great. Well, the spawner is right there. So let's, oh God, okay. Don't hit a pigman, please, God. Oh, hi. I like how you're just standing back there. Whoops, shooting at me like, all right, I'm just going to stand here. And when you take a minute to look at me, you know, you'll see. So what do we see? Where do we even need to go? That one right there, that center part right there, that's the tallest piece. And it's got a spawner on it. So let's see if we can get over there. Well, let's see if we can get over there, basically. Because I think I keep just getting overrun by bad guys. Let's drink this. Okay. Now, let's eat food because, well, there we go. Are you turning? Yeah, it's turning. I really don't want that spinning. Did I see spawner sparks or something down here? Or is that just my fire particles? Oh, I saw a chest. Chests don't give sparks. What the hell? What? Purple wool? Really? Cool. Yeah. I don't know why I'm surprised to find a wool. It's, oops. I mean, it's kind of what we're here for. But, well, okay. Well, how about this? Let's just see if we can get the hell out of here before we die. Run! Ish. Briskly jog. How about that? I couldn't get my run to work. That's when I would use the toggle, the sprint key. Control, you know, sprint key. Is at a time like that when I just don't want to lose my sprint. Well, cool. So we have purple wool. Did we get the blue wool out of that area down on the bottom part last episode? And if we did, ooh. If we did we put it on the monument? Let's go back here. Did we put it on a monument? Not the monument, a monument. Just some random monument somewhere. I'm sure I put blue wool on a monument at some point. No, not that. The legendary monument. The legendary blue wool. Is it legendary wool? Blue wool. I don't know how legendary you would say blue wool is. I guess it depends on your favorite color and your favorite textile type. Like, some people are allergic to wool. I don't know how much actual wool I've come in contact with growing up in the desert southwest. But, I seem to remember when I was little I had a wool sweater and it itched so bad. But whether it was real wool or some kind of acrylic or other blend, I don't remember. I was like 5. What can I say? We're lucky I remember having it. Whoo-wee. Well, that was successful. We got wool. Yay. We're only 6 minutes into the video and we've already gotten a wool. So I wonder if there's any more in the taco dungeon. I wonder if there's room for there to be any more in the taco dungeon. I really don't know. I think I want to get back to the victory monument, put the purple wool on here. And I want to see the status of the blue wool, because I know I've seen it. I think we got it out of that one area, didn't we? Maybe? I don't actually know. Whoops. Is it here? Yeah, there it is. See? Blue wool. Let's take these things back to the monument. What can we leave here? Didn't I pick up a ghast here? Or was that... Oh, no, wait. Never mind. Something else. All right. So let's go back to the victory monument, which is over... Do I have a minecart up there, I wonder? I don't know. We'll take this just in case. But it's up over here. And it's been a bit, so I might as well just get there on camera. Ah, damn, I do. Oh, well, that's okay. I'll just get here on camera. It's been a few days, and this maybe will help you guys kind of remember kind of where we were and what, you know, what we were doing. I mean, obviously, we are at the tail ass end of Legendary. That's that's where we are and what we're doing, but, you know, kind of where we are relative to other stuff. Well, that's a little bit easier to forget. So I don't know how much longer I have of Legendary. I want to get back to base, put the wool on the monument, and see for sure how many more wools we have. I think we have 4 more, maybe? 3 or 4. Did we find green? Have we found green? I don't know. We're gonna have to go look. I don't honestly know. I'm a little bit nervous we've missed one, to be honest. But if we have, I certainly don't know where we have. Do I have to pick up the minecart twice on the way back? Huh. Bah! This one, you really gotta be quick on the stick to get back in it, or it will take off without you. Not that I've ever been too slow on the uptake. Oh, no, no. I get in this cart flawlessly every single time, pets. Ahem. Absolutely, I do. And moving right along, before either any of you guys start examining me too closely for, you know, bald face lies, we'll just, you know, keep rolling, rolling, rolling in a minecart on the way to the victory monument. Yay! Put wool on there. Yay! Also, did I just leave the diamond block in the thing? Of course, I usually like to do the diamond block later in the thing. Like, do the diamond block at the same time as the black wool? Usually. Not always. Usually. My goodness, this is a long-ass ride! Jeez! Oh, we're here. Cool. That... you know what? Let me break you and stick you back on the track, because I don't really want you to take off. There we go. So, 1, 2, 3... Oh, we only need 2, I guess. And I guess it's red and black, maybe? Let's go see. I could stand over here and guess, but probably, certainly the easier thing to do would be to just get over yonder and look. Also, let's try not to miss any jumps. Yay! Always makes me happy when I can make it across here without missing jumps, just because I miss them just often enough. All right, let's grab some pumpkins, some jack-o'-lanterns, and put these on the bar. All right, what have we got here? We have purple wool. Get. Da-da-da-da! Blue wool, get. Da-da-da-da! Yay, purple and blue, what have we got? Red and black. And a gold block and a diamond block. Why don't we, because we need to do this anyway. Why don't we work on getting down to where the gold is? And then we can get that. Oh, you haven't grown yet because this chunk hasn't been loaded. You've been a baby for a long time, chicken. Like, several days. All right, so let's toss this in the chest. So we need to go in the giant spider place, right? So we need to do that. Also, we need to go in the, you know what? We don't have our thing. So I'm going to go ahead and put low-level enchants on these, and I know I shouldn't. But here's why. I really want the raw defense. I just want the... my nose itches. I just want the protection of the diamond gear. We're in a hard part of the map, pets. If not now, when? We need two more wools, and that's it. So I think... Yeah, this is what I have left for blocks, by the way. Do I want to use gravity blocks to get down to where that gold is, or do I just want to... I don't think I want to use gravity blocks. I think I just want to pearl down and then ladder and pillar back up. All right, so let's get back to where we're going. What are we going to do for the rest of the episode? Well, I guess we'll get back to that giant spider. Because that's kind of the next place to go. Well, first, we'll stop at base. Ooh, I wasn't sure I was going to make that jump because it wasn't a sprint jump. We'll get back to base. Oh, hi, Flappaderp. And go ahead and enchant this chain and this hat. Or not this chain, this chest. Diamond chest. And the diamond hat. And we'll see what we can get. But I think I'm honestly just going to do them for like a level apiece. Sorry, I had to rub at my... But yeah, I think I'm just going to enchant them for, did I say a buck? One level each and get protection on them. That's a waste of diamond armor, and I know it's a waste of diamond armor. Actually, no, it's not. It would be more of a waste of diamond armor to not put any enchant on them at all. This way, at least it's something, and at least it will give us that defense. It will give us that protection, and maybe it'll keep us from getting our asses handed to us in the end of the map, pets, because, look, I know Vechs enough to know what he's going to do to us in this black wool area. Yeah. And obviously it's the black wool area. It's the last area of the map. Now I think in Kaizo Caverns, I think the black wool was the first wool, wasn't it? But what's funny is that, but I don't know like if all the wool was reversed or just the black or, I don't know. It doesn't matter. Although it will be nice to get back to the land of the fleecy boxes, but come to think of it, now he has said that once he got super hostile online rolling well, that he was going to do, you know, another regular super hostile map. Whoa, shit. Oh wait, ah, I hit the cart. Why didn't it break? Come here, cart. Oh, apparently I don't have infinity. No, I don't. I can't hit it now. Thank you. Goodness. That's what I usually do when my cart gets away from me. I sit here and shoot it. But if I shoot it and it doesn't do anything about the cart, well, then that's kind of sucky, isn't it? Let's go slowly, slowly. There we go. Okay, we're going. Anyway, so what was I saying? Oh, yeah. He said he's going to do a more traditional CTM map. Or, well, he's going to make a downloadable super hostile map. I don't know whether that's going to be a traditional. Traditional as in you go through dungeons and gather wool, or if he's going to change it up somehow. I have no idea. I'm not even sure he does, to be honest, pets. He hasn't said much about that. Obviously, super hostile online has been his focus because there's been a lot of things that he's had to figure out kind of how to do you know, and how to make things work the way he wants them to work. So it's been an interesting ride so far. Yeah, but I hope you guys all saw, I'm sure you all did. Protection one. This kills me, you guys. Like, you have no idea, okay, how much it hurts me to do that. But I need. And I would rather have higher level on that. And honestly, that, because that gets rid of spawners faster. There's our gold block. We need a diamond block. There's our diamond block. We need a gold block. I need to stop trying to talk while I'm looking at other things. I thought I had some decent boots. Maybe that was in a different map. Meh. I don't know. Yeah, so I hope you guys saw the project we did together. It was a lot of fun. What do I have for blocks? Let's go ahead and let's go get... I'm going to use sandstone for this next project. Well, yeah, I'll come back here. I was trying to decide whether I wanted to bring blocks with so that I could go on to the next thing, or damn it, I forgot the cart. Because we're going to go into the giant spider after we get the gold, but I think getting the gold is probably going to take up pretty much the rest of this episode, so I'll be coming back here between episodes anyway, so there's no point in bringing the blocks back. That's kind of where I was going with that whole mess of thought there. Sheesh. Alright. So, let's get this going. My husband took my son and my son's friend and my daughter over to the carnival. So I'm trying to get this done before they get back because it's nice and quiet in my house right now, so. Oh, let's scoot. My son just turned 10 a few days ago. He's pretty excited about that. Actually, yesterday, I think. I mean, no, I don't mean I think. It's just I'm trying to think when this is going to go up. His birthday is May 5th. He's a Cinco de Mayo baby, so. Yep. But we didn't do much on his actual for real birthday. He's having a friend spend the night tonight, and then tomorrow we're taking him to Flagstaff to visit my brother and my sister-in-law and their baby and stuff. So, yeah, pretty cool indeed. Are you going to stay there? Are you going to fidget back and forth and then finally take off? Okay, you're going to stay. Let's hurry before it changes its mind. You know those minecarts, something people don't realize? They get separation anxiety too and try to follow you. They do. People don't believe it because people never see it, but trust me, I know these things about this game. Also, that one random block of glass right there is going to drive me nuts. There. I didn't want to silk touch it. Then I would have had a random piece of glass. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to be very brave. We're going to... The souls of those who fail my maps don't go to heaven. Instead, I put them here as combat slaves. Right. I knew it said words to that effect. Something like that. Combat slaves, huh? So, if I enderpearl straight down, I'm going to enderpearl into a pigman, but also... That scared. Did you guys see that? That pigman despawned just as I threw the pearl, and I thought he had somehow glitched and landed, like, under the pearl or something, and I was like, oh no. Alright, let's be careful. And be very careful putting out fires in the nether, because, whoops, if there's a... baby pigman in the fire, you can't see it. And you're liable to end up patting him on the head. And they don't like that. Ask my husband. He got wrecked one time. He was putting out fires in the nether. And there was a baby pigman being sneaky and sly, hiding inside the fire. It was bad. I don't think my husband could go in the nether forever because that was when the pigmen were, their aggro was different. And he was just kind of screwed for a while. Alright, so that's 8 pieces. We need, what, 9? So I'm not gonna make a freaking notch apple or anything. I wonder if there's any loot chests or anything down here. Huh, that's a thought. I don't see anything, and there's a lot of these islands around. Huh, this is an interesting point of view. Well, that's 11 pieces. I think probably we're gonna call 11 pieces good enough. And we're gonna... Ah! We're gonna hop up here. Okay, pigmen. You guys can all just, you know, keep doing what you're doing. I'm just gonna pillar from here. I know this isn't quite straight up, but close enough. I kind of wish... Whoops. I don't know what I was trying to do there. I kind of wish I could get back up here some other way than using these blocks, but, well, whatever. Pardon me. Thanks, fellas. Up. There we go. Okay. Let's go very carefully over here. Whoo-wee. Well, I think actually this is a short episode, but I've had some really long episodes lately, you guys, with SHO and stuff, so. And I think this is probably a good stopping point. I'm trying to stop and think if there's any other real quick stuff we can do, because in order to get over to where we need to be for the rest of the wool, I think I'm going to assume that both pieces of wool that are remaining are both in that giant spider. That takes a few minutes to get to. And so I don't really want to start over there at this point in the episode. So I'm going to end this. But next episode, pets, I think we'll go ahead and start up right there at the giant spider. And we'll see if we can finish this map. Everybody, thank you guys so much for watching. And I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know what you thought. And I'll see you all real soon. Take care. Bye now.